statement from the German government in the last few moments. The German government has said that training of Ukrainian troops is to begin in Germany soon. Germany will also provide logistics, ammunition and maintenance to the Ukrainian armed forces. The German government says the goal is to quickly establish two battalions with Leopard 2 tanks for Ukraine. Initially, it will provide a company of 14 Leopard 2 A6 tanks from its military stocks. The German government has also confirmed that it is to approve the re-export of German 2 tanks from partner countries. Obviously, you will recall that earlier in the week, the Polish government formally applied to Germany for the right to re-export its own Leopard 2 tanks to Ukraine. Obviously, as things stand, Germany has to be able to approve the re-export of German-manufactured tanks to Ukraine. We can go to our correspondent, Siobhan Robbins, who's in Berlin. Siobhan, I mean, it looks like the German government has caved in after an enormous amount of pressure from its allies.
Yes, we'd been expecting this, much speculation coming in last night that Germany was poised to announce not only that it would be sending a company of its own Leopard 2 tanks, but it would finally allow allies to re-export their own stocks. And this, as you say, is after immense pressure, particularly from neighbours, including Poland, who for the last couple of weeks have really been ramping up their criticism of Germany, saying that if they didn't get official permission to send their Leopard 2 tanks, they might just make a coalition and send them anyway. Now, many people had been speculating that this decision could come last Friday, when, of course, we saw dozens of defence ministers meet at Ramstein. It didn't. And when we asked the question why, sources here have been suggesting two things. One, the Chancellor is a particular character. He doesn't like to be pushed. He likes to make decisions in his own time. And there was a real feeling that there was a concern about the fact that by sending Leopard 2 tanks, there could be an escalation in the war. And also that if Germany did this alone, it potentially could be a target. So we did, of course, see the UK pledging to send 14 of its own Challenger 2 battle tanks. That didn't seem to be enough, though. And there was a feeling, particularly last week, that conversations were going on behind the scenes with US officials trying to get a similar pledge from the US to send some of their Abrams battle tanks. Now, the word we're getting out of the US is that following an announcement today by Germany that we're going to expect to see a similar pledge by the US. And this is an important step because we know that there are around 2,000 Leopard 2 tanks around the world. Many of them are in Europe. The exact numbers of how many can be pledged, we still don't know. We know that Ukraine is looking for around 300, and how many go will depend on how big a difference they will make. But these modern tanks will make a difference because, as you've seen in our reporting, from Ukraine, for example, from my colleague Alex Rossi, many of the Ukrainians fighting are using old Soviet tanks. So the fact that they can use these modern battle tanks will make a difference. There are still things to be ironed out. How quickly will they go? How many will go, of course, as I was saying? How long will the training take? And also, how will the Kremlin now react?